Hi folks, it's Chris Slogar from BuckeyeInklings.com. I want to show you a cute little gift card holder that we made in club this month. I cased this project from Julie DiMatteo at the Paper Pixie. She has a version and I will link you to it also in the blog post that goes with this video. She used Candy Cane Season, also super cute. I love this Festive Farmhouse, so I had to use that. But let me show you what it is. It's a gift card holder. And the belly band slides off, and I just think it's a cute little shape that's so different from what we normally have. This opens like so, and this is just a regular envelope, a medium vanilla envelope. Okay, and that makes up most of the base. So, as you can see, this is going to be super cute and super quick. All right, so I just need my scoring board and a medium envelope. I've got that envelope opened up and I'm going to put it on my scoring tool and score at 1¾ and 4 inches. And then I will fold and burnish those long scores first and then fold in this flap. Okay, so this is the base of the gift card holder, and we're going to mount it on a piece of mossy metal. This measures 2½ by 4⅝, and so I'm just going onto the back of that folded envelope piece that we have and adding my adhesive. And putting that in on my mossy metal mat piece. And then the designer paper that makes up the front only attaches to the flap. So that piece measures 2 by 4⅛, and I'm going to put the adhesive on the flap so that I don't take it too far on the designer paper. And I will put that in place and just get that centered. Okay, and that's basically the whole base. And then what we've got is a belly band around it to hold it shut. So I have a piece of cherry cobbler that measures 1 inch by 6 inches. I didn't pre-score it. I want to fold it and even fold it so that it's just a little bit loose, so it's not too hard to slide on and off. And let me grab my fast fuse so we don't have to wait for that to dry. Okay, and then I have a cherry cobbler scallop circle already cut. And I've pre-stamped these pieces. These are from the same stamp, Wishing You a Season Full of Peace, Wonder, and Love. And I've stamped it first in Old Olive on Old Olive. So then I could punch that with a 2-inch circle. And then I stamped it in cherry cobbler on crumb cake, and I cut that out with a framelit that goes with that farmhouse set. Okay, and then I'm gonna take also from that farmhouse set this really great striped burlap, and I'm going to put that down over the old olive piece. I'm just gonna get a couple of glue dots here and stick that down. Might need to trim that shorter later. And then I've got some dimensionals. I'm going to span them off the edge of the burlap so they also catch the cardstock a little bit. Otherwise, I'm afraid they might pull off the burlap. Okay, so I'm just going to put that Merry Christmas down over the top of that. And then I have already threaded and tied with a knot of this cotton twine. These are all the galvanized buttons and the cotton twine. Those are all part of the Festive Farmhouse suite. And I'm just gonna put that on with a glue dot right down there, and that's it. So, of course, very good project to modify to your favorite papers and stamp sets. And really, thanks so much to Julie DiMatteo. I just love this little gift card holder. If you need any of the products that you see here, please visit me at BuckeyeInklings.com. And otherwise, there are also great project ideas there. Thanks so much. Bye.